G'day, Chris here, and welcome back to Clickspring. I'm about to drill and tap some small retaining screw holes in this bezel, and I've got quite a bit of time invested in the part, so I'm taking it very carefully. The wheel crossing jig is perfect for laying out the positions. The wheel is held on with double-sided tape, and the holes and turning marks in the jig mean that it's easy to centrally position the work by eye. A light centre punch marks the hole locations, and then the work is positioned on the mill on a piece of melamine, so that it can float around and find its own centre under the drill bit. Now this mill doesn't have a depth stop, so I'm using the digital readout to control the depth and the fine handwheel to move the quill. For a mid-sized benchtop mill, it has quite a sensitive feel. This hole is about 3 millimetres deep, and I want the thread to go right to the bottom. So I've modified this 10BA plug tap to be even shorter. It now has almost no taper at all and should give me what I want. The light feel of this pinvise means that I can tell if I'm getting close to breaking the tap, and it slides on this rod in the quill, so vertical alignment is sorted. A quick de-burr with a handheld countersink, and the job is done. Thanks for watching. I'll see you later. If you'd like to see how these holes are used to fasten the chaptering in place, then be sure to check out this other video. And if this is your first time visiting the channel, thanks for dropping by. I'd like you to know that I post regular project videos about shop-made tools, as well as a longer-term clockmaking project, so be sure to subscribe. And have a look at the Clickspring Projects website too, for more toolmaking project info. Thanks again for watching. I'll catch you on the next video.